Dear friends, here we will study the concepts of psychrometry here, the fundamentals of psychrometry, some definitions, etc. So first we will discuss the definitions of psychrometry: dry bulb temperature, wet bulb temperature, wet bulb depression, and dew point temperature, relative humidity, specific humidity, humidity ratio, and absolute humidity. And these are properties of psychrometry. So first we'll discuss the definition of the psychrometry. So before psychrometry definition, list the applications of psychrometry. So applications of psychrometry is here: drying of cloths even in shade. This is one example every day you'll see in our daily life. The drying of sweat from our skin body. The cooling of air by desert cooler, that is called evaporative cooling. The cooling of water kept in clay pitcher. So this example you might have seen in summer cases, the clay pitcher, water will get cooled. And one more example, water droplets on grass or leaves in early morning. So when you go for walking or jogging in the early morning, you might have seen some water droplets on the leaves and grass. So all these are examples which are arrived in our daily life. The phenomenon behind these all examples are psychrometry. So now, so discuss the definition of the psychrometry. Psychrometry is a branch of science which deals with the study of thermodynamics properties of atmospheric air. So thermodynamic properties, nothing but pressure, temperature, saturation pressure, etc. And now the question arises, what is atmospheric air here? So atmospheric air is a combination of dry air, moisture content, and pollutants. And dear students, out of these three, the pollutants can be removed easily from the atmospheric air by doing filtration process. But these two are cannot be removed easily. So dry air, it is there are 17 types of gases will be inside the dry air. For example, the percentage of nitrogen is more, that is 78%. The 22% is oxygen. Understood? Some books will study that 77% of nitrogen, 22% of oxygen, and remaining 1% is remaining 13 gases. So it is a combination of many gases. We will call it as dry air. And moisture content is, that is water vapor. So combination of these two is called atmospheric air. So to study the thermodynamics properties, pressure of atmosphere, volume of atmosphere, air, and temperature of the atmosphere, and what temperature the water vapor condenses to liquid. So all those study deals with is called psychrometry. The principles of psychrometry are useful to engineers concerned with heating, cooling, ventilation of buildings, ships, and aircrafts. And these are examples of in a real engineering field. Okay. In general, the psychrometry is a study of air conditioning systems. So all these examples, heating, cooling, ventilation of buildings, all these are a category under air conditioning systems. So in general, we can say that the psychrometry is a study of science which deals with the study of air conditioning systems. So now, so first property of air is dry bulb temperature. So dry bulb temperature, in short form, we'll write dBT. It is in also represented by TdB. T for temperature, D for dry, B for bulb. Dry bulb temperature. So what is the definition of the dry bulb temperature? So it is a temperature measured by an ordinary thermometer placed in air and water vapor mixture. So for example, here I will consider one thermometer. Okay, thermometer. And the thermal bulb is here. So now this thermometer is kept inside atmospheric air. You assume atmospheric air is there. So when you put this thermometer inside the atmospheric air, the level of mercury will rise because the temperature of the atmosphere is more, So it is giving a reading of 50 degree Celsius. So 50 degree Celsius is the temperature of this atmosphere. Understood? So that will be represented with TdB. TdB is equal to 50 degree Celsius. Next, the second property of the air is wet bulb temperature. So wet bulb temperature, in short form, we'll write WBT, or it will also represented with T suffix WB. T for temperature again here, W for wet, B for bulb temperature. So now consider one thermometer, just like in the previous case, high bulb temperature. So thermometer, now the bulb of the thermometer is wrapped with wet cotton wick. Understood? So we have taken some cotton, wet condition. That wet cotton wick is wrapped with the bulb. Okay, now measure the temperature of this atmosphere. So if I consider here some atmosphere, air is there. So measure the temperature of the atmosphere air. Then the level of the mercury will does not rise as much as in the dry bulb temperature. The reading on this thermometer is 35 degrees Celsius. Then in the previous case, the reading was 50 degree. But due to this wrap condition, due to this wet cotton wick, it is wrapped over the bulb, the temperature fell below 50, that is 35 degrees the reading. The reason is, when this atmospheric air crosses through this bulb or passes through this bulb, the air is unsaturated. The unsaturated air absorb water from the wick, absorb water from the wet cotton wick. Then the cooling effect takes place inside the bulb. So due to cooling effect, there is no rise of mercury level inside the thermometer. So temperature will be less than the dry bulb temperature. Here on an average, just an example, I have taken 35 degrees Celsius. Now definition of wet bulb temperature is, it is a temperature measured by a thermometer. Here is a thermometer. The bulb is wrapped or covered thoroughly with wet cotton wick. So this is the bulb. The bulb is covered with blue color cotton wick. And this thermometer is placed in an air water mixture. Here is a air water mixture. So this is called wet bulb temperature. Now wet bulb depression. This is third property. The difference between dry bulb temperature and wet bulb temperature is called wet bulb depression. Now, so well, wet bulb depression value will be more when WBT is less. What does it mean is, so if the air is unsaturated, it needs water to become saturated. So if it is more unsaturated air, the more cooling effect takes place. Due to more cooling effect on the surface of the bulb, there is no rise in mercury level in the thermometer. Still the temperature will come down below 35 degree. So for example, 25 degree Celsius. So dry bulb temperature is 50 degree minus 25. So 50 minus 25 is again 25. The value of wet bulb depression will increase. So the value of wet bulb depression, it depends on, as the value of wet bulb depression increases, means WBT should decrease. When the value of WBT is less, the wet bulb depression will be more. Understood? Okay. Next. So this is one sketch I have taken here. So again, I have taken one thermometer. So this red color indicates the level of mercury here. This is the level of mercury. And here is the bulb. On the surface of the bulb, it is wrapped with cotton wick. That is wet cotton wick. It has some water content. Now atmospheric air is here. It is atmospheric air. It is purely dry air. There is no moisture content. There is no water. So this atmospheric air is a thirsty nature. It needs some water to become saturated. So this unsaturated air or dry air, when passes over the surface of this wick, surface of this bulb, so this air absorbs water from the cotton wick, and cooling effect takes place on the inside surface of the bulb. Understood? So cooling effect takes place when there is no rise of mercury level. If there is no cooling effect, obviously there is a sudden rise in mercury level. But due to cooling effect, there is no rise in temperature. So the temperature will fall down, and air absorbs all the water content from the weak condition, and later it, when it comes on the right hand side, it will become dry air plus water vapor. And in this region the cooling effect takes place at the weak surface. So this is wet bulb temperature concept. Next, dew point temperature. So it is a temperature at which the atmosphere water vapor condenses to liquid droplets at constant pressure. One example you have written: droplets of water on grass in early morning. This is an example here. So the temperature at which the atmospheric water vapor condenses to liquid. At what temperature the atmosphere water vapor is condensed to liquid, that temperature we will call it as dew point temperature.